I'm the hallelujah lady, JoAnna Ward. You're on the move with JoAnna Ward. Thank you so much for joining us, tuning in, taking care of yourself, doing all things faith and fitness. We're back with our Soldiers Trails because you guys loved it so much, we bought it back. But we're not going to do the same thing. We're going to do something different. And I've bought with me one of my classmates from South Carolina State University for over 25 years, Erica Jennings. How are you, Erica?
I'm doing well, thank you, Joanne.
And how much have you lost since you became an empty nester and decided to get your body back?
Probably 30 pounds in over 4 months, maybe. Mm-hmm.
About 30 pounds, so that's a little less than 10 pounds a month, so you just gotta appreciate that 1 to 1.5 pounds a week that comes off, and before you know it, you'll be saying, hey, you know, I dropped 20, 30 pounds. Now, you have some work you wanna do because you wanna get ready for homecoming.
Yes, I do.
Because, you know, we always have to stun, we go back to homecoming. And if you wanna do that a faith and fitness way, of course, you come see your classmate, JoAnna Ward.
Exactly.
So you guys, again, remember, if you don't have boxes like these, you should have ordered them off our website, but if you didn't, that's okay. You can use towels, you can use bricks, you can use anything that's gonna give you some distance and cause you to lift up your legs. So Erica and I are gonna start with a warm-up, and then I'll do the demonstration for what it is that we're gonna do over the boxes. So Erica has a set of weights, and so do I, and we wanna add some upper body work, so we're gonna actually warm up with our weights, okay? Erica, we're gonna start right here, smoothly punching down right and left, using our abs. So what you guys are gonna know about Erica and these boxes, and the reason that they're so cool is because Erica was in the marching 101.
Yay.
So when it comes to right, left, right, she has that right. So Erica, what's the name of that band sorority that you're in?
Tau Beta Sigma, National Honorary Band Sorority.
Say it again.
Tau Beta Sigma.
Uh-huh.
National Honorary Band Sorority.
Okay then, see that's what I'm talking about.
Founded 1946.
Okay, if y'all down with that, go ahead and go to the website and let me know that you down with Erica. And you gonna keep marching even after the fact, right Erica?
Right.
See, Erica has children, is getting ready to have children, so she gotta keep herself in shape.
Exactly.
And just like faith, fitness is one of those things you have to work out with your own salvation and fear and trembling. Nobody can do it for you. Okay Erica, we're gonna punch out here. And we're breathing, spinning, spinning, working all those muscles right here. And we're gonna go into some shoulder presses and do side-to-side taps on 4, 3, 2, and 1. Here we go. Breathing. Good job. 4 more. 3, 2 to chest press, last one, chest press right here. Still breathing. Good job. You getting warm, Erica?
Getting warm.
Erica, like, I don't talk and work out. I don't talk and work out.
I don't.
I focus, especially when I'm on TV. I focus. We're gonna do 4 more. 3, 2 to march with biceps. 1, and we're gonna march right here. Erica, say, that's not marching, that's heel digs. I know what marching is. We are the marching.
It's been 30 years, but yeah.
30 years. Yeah. So she's been knowing me 25. She's been in the band. Been 30 years. Getting ready to go to celebration. What is it called? Your anniversary?
Yeah.
30th year.
26 years in the sorority.
Okay. So we're gonna stretch out here, just loosen up our legs, because that's what we're gonna use. We're gonna keep our weights in our hands the entire time. We're gonna have that body-brain coordination, which is so very important when it comes to your memory and fighting off dementia and other age-related mental diseases that are avoidable if you use your brain as the muscle that it is. So Erica, what we're gonna do is we're gonna come down here and we're gonna step up. We're gonna go right and down. We're gonna do 2, 3, and then we're gonna walk to the next one. And we're gonna switch left, 2, you behind me, Erica?
Yeah.
3, and we're gonna do right again. 1, 2, and 3. You got it?
I think so.
1, good. 2, good. 3, and step, we're gonna switch kicks. Right there, good. Perfect, 1, 2, excellent. 3, awesome, let's step again with the right, you guys. 1, 2, bicep curls, and 3, we're gonna step. Other leg on the left, Breathing, two, three. We're gonna step and right. One, two, and three. Too slow for you? You gotta get out of the way.
No.
Perfect. So we're gonna switch it up a little bit. We're gonna lead with that right and kick with the left this time. Three, two, one, and I'm gonna go to right here. Three, two, one. I'm gonna do the left. Three, two, one. Y'all mess with band people because they know how to do it.
We try.
Eric, like, I only need to see the step once. I know how the whole right, left thing go. You only got the 2 feet. All you got to do is show me where you want me to put them, and I got it. Okay, so you guys are going to put up on the right. And just like we did before, we're going to do three kicks like Eric is doing. And I'm going to come here, and I'm going to kick, stepping left, kick with the right for three, two, one, and go back to that left kick. Two, and one, good job. Get it, Eric. See, I'm telling you, you guys are gonna love my book, Faith and Fitness Over 40, Faith and Fitness Over 50, and Eric is about that life. You gotta be about that faith and fitness life. Good job, Erica. That's perfect. So again, remember, if this is a towel, you're just gonna use the same parameters as if you're stepping on a towel or a band or a box or anything else. So Erica, we're gonna do delts. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna start off over to the right and left, and we're gonna do three, and then we're gonna come back and do start with the left and do the right. And again, here's how that's gonna go. It's gonna go right, left, right, left. We're gonna step left and go right, left, right, and left. So it's a four count, step left, right, left, right, left, and step off. Left, good, way to make up for it. Right, good job. Now you're gonna step with your left, perfect. You're gonna do four, good job. Three, two, come off on the left, and step left, perfect. So we have two more, just like that. Always stepping with that left, and lean to the right, lean to the left, right, and after I go to the left, I'm gonna lead with that left again. Stepping to the right, left, right, left. Remember, step and lead left, but go to the right. And lead left. And it's okay if you don't get it right the first time. This is all about putting the work in, you know? When you first start a class, you have to get down with the concept. You know what you signed up for, but learning the content and the subject matter, studying, practicing, that's how you earn your A. So it's the same thing with fitness. It's amazing how many people step with my left and go to the right, say, well, I need to get in shape before I can come and get in shape. Step with the left. And I'm gonna step with the left. And right, left, right, left. Good. And so on this one here, it's gonna be a different lead. So we're leading with the right and stepping to the left. Lean with it, rock with it, lean with it, rock with it. To the left, to the left, to the left, to the left, to the left. Let me show you guys real quick how it would look on your towel. So here's my towel. I'm gonna step up on my towel with my right. If you're doing this at home, you go ahead and step with your right with me. You're gonna lean with it, rock with it, lean with it, rock with it, lean with it, rock with it, lean. And we're gonna step right, not left, so that we can go to the left. Bam, 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 bam. This is for you tile people, okay? And we're gonna step with that right, so we can go left. So that's how it's gonna look if you're doing it on the floor. Me and Eric are gonna get back on the box because we actually gonna get a workout. You see this, the sweat? Ooh. The more you put in, like, you know, your paycheck, when you deposit in the bank, you deposit $5, you know, you can get it to your goal a little slower than if you deposited 50. So we're gonna step with that right, left, left, right. I'm gonna step right so I can go left. Lean with it, rock with it, lean with it, rock, lean, rock. Step right, so that I can lean left, okay? Right, left, right. And I'm always gonna lead with my right this time. You got it? Okay, step right, lean left. So you're gonna come off to the left, come to my left, over here. Step left, left, for four, three, two, go all the way off to the right, all the way off to the right, and step with the right. Now step forward with your right, right. Good, and you'll come to the left. Perfect. Right, left, and right. Come straight from the floor, to, yeah. And go to the left.
Oh, left.
Yeah, that's okay. You're doing good, you're up there. Good. Perfect, perfect. Awesome sauce. So we have two more of these, Erica, so by the third one, you'll have it all the way down. So you're doing good. Erica's like, let me get a swipe of sweat off me.
Yeah.
I'm not mad at her. I mean, I would swipe my sweat, but I don't really have breaks like that because, you know, I'm about to run out of town because we got to talk to our next guest and see what's going on. So remember, lead with your right, and it's kind of in a fluid motion, left, right, left, right. So from the floor, from your towel, this off the floor, stepping off the floor, you're going to leap that right so you can go left, okay? And so from the floor, I'm going to go here. With that right. All right? And I'm gonna step right. Left.
Left.
Good. Right? Perfect. Left. Excellent. Are you working, Eric, or is it just?
Whew. It's going.
Okay.
I can feel the burn.
You feel the burn?
Oh, excuse me.
Good job. All right, you got one more of these, Erica. This is just three's a charm. Three's a charm. I know you got it.
That was my line number.
That's your line number? Three?
Yes.
That's what's up. One for the Father, the Son, the Holy Ghost.
Amen. Hallelujah.
So we're back up here with that right. So we're going to go left, right, left, right. And I'm going to step from right here again so that I can go to the floor on my left. That's four, three, two, one. From here, I'm going to step with this right. Four, three, two, and one. Good, Erica. Good job. Way to hang in there. Step with that right. Perfect. Left. Good job. Excellent. That's what I'm talking about. I love it. I love it. I love the inspiration and the motivation. That is awesome. That's awesome. So, Erica, we're going to put our weights down. You did that. Give me five.
Yes.
Want to let you guys know, so Erica, we're gonna come up here and we're gonna just cool down so you can get in that space right there between that box. We're gonna stand here. I just want you guys to know this is never, ever too late to start taking care of your body. And while you're taking care of your body, you're taking care simultaneously, you're taking care of your mind and your soul. You know what I mean? So I need you to get past looking good, losing weight, and all that other stuff, and understand that this is gonna keep depression away. When you're feeling anxious, you're feeling bad, you're feeling sad, you're feeling mad, you have all these different issues that's coming. Believe it or not, something as simple as exercise takes care of all that. That's right, God gave you a built-in trainer for your own body. We'll be back. I gotta wipe this sweat off. Erica gotta run. But we'll be back with our next guest. And we hope that you stay tuned and come back too. We'll be back in a moment.
The Spirit, Mind, and Body Workout with JoAnna Ward Fitness.
Welcome back. You're back with JoAnna. You're on the move. I hope you guys enjoyed that wonderful workout and that you got you some water and now you're resting because you're getting ready to hear a really great word from one of our very own here at WATC 57, producer of Atlanta Live, Mrs. Jennifer Eichelberger. Thank you so much for joining us on the move. I'd love to have you because you're so awesome.
Thank you
for having
me.
You have so much juice. You know what I mean? You have so much, what they call the juice.
Is that what they call it now?
Yes, because that's the good stuff that's inside of fruit.
Oh, okay.
And you always have the juice.
Okay.
And you have some juicy stuff for us today, some wonderful things that are going to hydrate us at the spiritual, mental, emotional, psychological level, because a lot of us are just dry, and we're in a dry place. We're in a thirsty and an arid place, and there's some things that we're just doing to go along and get along, and you're going to tell us a little bit about that today. So so tell us what this particular JoAnna and Jennifer juiciness is going to be about today.
Well, the juice is what we're going to talk about today. I had a an incident that happened not too long ago where someone, I was helping someone with a mic, and she just out of the blue says, "That's a bold step you're taking not to wear makeup." And I said, "Huh? What in the world is this coming from?"
And you weren't on a set or anything?
No, no, no,
you weren't going to a wedding or some outing. You were just doing your job.
Just doing my job.
Which is a very intense,
it can be
rigorous job. It requires physical fitness and not necessarily glam and glitz.
Absolutely, because I, you know, I'm not on camera. So, and I just
thought. And so the expectation, do you know why she expected you to be full in full makeup doing your job? Where is this expectation coming from?
I don't know where the, but you know what? I gave that some thought, and actually it has kind of, led me to, you know, maybe start a ministry, incorporate that into, you know, my ministry I already have.
Right.
Is that I think some of it has come from some of the reality TV shows where we feel that we've gotten comfortable because we see it on some of the reality TV shows. We feel that we can say anything to
the
to,
audacity, the let me be confrontational, let me be as messy. I got it. Okay.
That's what I think.
And this kind of sassiness of like, let me just, you know, put it out there to try to see what kind of rise I can get. That's a maybe subconscious level she was doing that, but unintentionally, not knowing the consequence behind it. You know what I mean? Like, she, I don't think she probably felt the full breadth of what it was she was doing. And a lot of times we are doing things from a subconscious level. We've absorbed these things through these different things that we're eating through our eyes and hearing through our ears. And so we're mimicking this stuff inadvertently. So what do we do? How do we pull away from that falsehood? Because that's what it is.
Exactly.
It's a lie that you have to have on makeup. I get it. You know, if you're going to a wedding, you're going to ministry, you're going to do something like that. I understand, you know, the lights and everything because we're in television. So, you know, you're a producer. And being that you're a producer and you're in television, you teach and coach people, I think that's extremely important what you're talking about because people can be obsessed with what they see on television.
Absolutely.
So much so when you're doing your basic job, your focus is not how I look, it's how my guests look. I'm trying to help you.
Exactly.
And you're worried about how I look.
Exactly.
So what does the word have to say about
this issue? I think, you know what, we need to concentrate on what God, what the Bible has to say. We are fearfully and wonderfully made.
Amen.
Whether we have on makeup or not.
Yes. Yes.
You know,
absolutely.
The
Amen.
Beauty comes from inside. And what's the scripture? Because you know all the scriptures. Proverbs, it says what? Beauty is...
Beauty is deceitful and favor is vain, but a woman that... favor is deceitful.
Right.
And beauty is vain, but a woman that fears the Lord shall be praised. And,
right.
And I think that's probably that latter part is the part that's actually missing. We don't fear the Lord. We fear and favor everyone else, and we have this vacuum cleaner mentality when it comes to getting people's approval and then trying to get them to get our approval.
And I read something like on social media. It said, well, it was on social media, but it says social media has created this platform where it causes us to say what we want to say to people because, you know, they're not there. They could be thousands of miles away, literally.
True, yes.
And, you know, the chances of you running into person is, you know, a million to one.
Right.
And also we feel that now with selfies, we got to look a certain way and be a certain way and all of that.
Lighting.
But you have to remember what your beauty is on the inside.
Right, right, right.
The word of God even says that.
Amen. And it's your countenance more than what you look like or what you
Absolutely.
Wear. It's what you're wearing as a countenance of a virtuous woman. And we take that out of context sometimes too, thinking that that means something other than the countenance of the Lord is resting upon who you are as a person and your entire life. And I tell people all the time, don't be so socially exposed out there on the internet that when people really see you, they don't know who you are.
That's a good point.
You have so much going on that you've made up and pretense, and that's what this leveling the playing field of digital manipulation has done to us. It makes us actually believe the lie that we're putting out there to other people.
See?
And so when we come in person, we actually expect you to be the lie too. Oh, I can't believe it. You're not some made up filtered version of yourself. Really? In reality is not even reality. It's a version of what we think people want to see.
And whether you wear makeup or not, you're still beautiful.
Right.
I mean, some people have allergic reactions to different makeups.
Yeah. I don't wear it because I'm not going to be spending all that money on makeup.
First of all. But it's my money and something else.
Right. And then the number of times that I actually work out and sweat, what I'm going to sweat off makeup, it's just too much, really.
Yes.
For me to want to do that on a day-to-day basis because I believe that that's what's real, and it's really not. I don't even want it all over my clothes and things like that. I have too much work to do, so I don't put on a lot of stuff that I have to take off. I need, and I don't want to offend anyone, but I can't help that because the truth just does that. It doesn't apologize, and it doesn't ask permission, so I hope you're not offended by this, but my eyes, I should be able to see. So if I have on 4-inch eyelashes, that probably is impeding me from being able to see, mm-hmm. spiritually as well as physically. Mm-hmm. I'm a woman. When you talk about virtue, she's a working woman. And so also with my fingernails, and I know people wear fake fingernails and that kind of stuff, but as for me, I have so many things that I have to do with my hands.
Right.
I have so much mm-hmm. work that I have to do. And people say they're a virtuous woman, but it says she works willingly and diligently with
Absolutely.
Her hands.
Absolutely.
And so I have so much to do, so many things to make. I make products. I work out. I have to move weights. Those get in my way. So now I have my eyes and my hands that are impaired by various things. And then, you know, here on our head, we're quick to throw different things, you know, on our head just to say we have hair that looks a certain way, not knowing the kernel impact of having so many different coverings. We have live hair on our heads, which has DNA in it. So now someone else's DNA is on our heads night and day, and we wonder why our thoughts are off, why I'm so jealous, why I'm so insecure. And we're never really putting thought into it. So I'm glad you brought this up. We're never putting thought into what is causing us to have these actions, reactions, and interactions with people.
See?
Like that lady had
That's
with
good.
You.
Mm-hmm.
Where's your makeup? How dare you be so comfortable and confident in yourself that you come to do this without mm-hmm. being all over the top.
Mm-hmm.
And anybody who knows me, I've seen so many of our viewers out on the streets. They'll see I'm on my tights, tennis shoes, t-shirt, ponytail. I'm not saying if you dress up in a suit, that's your job.
That's fine.
My job mm-hmm. is fitness. My job is faith. I'm in the trenches. Mm-hmm. So when you see me in the store, I'm not going to have on this makeup. I'm just not. It's not what I do every day. It's not necessary. It's not even practical. And I think we've gotten away from what's practical. It wasn't
Absolutely.
Practical for you as a producer to be dressed down to the nines.
And those lights are hot.
They're very hot.
And you're, yeah. Because there were a time or two that I had my face made up mm-hmm. and because I was having a headshot, and I went home and I was washing my face and I said, that was whatever I paid for. I said, this is money literally going down the drain.
But that was for that headshot. Because we do want to put our best first.
Absolutely.
Because you speak, you're a minister, mm-hmm. You have things that you're doing and you're promoting, so we do want you to be your best on those.
Absolutely.
But there's a disconnect between you realizing when I'm actually working and when I'm presenting. And
right.
And this needs to be addressed. And so I'm so mm-hmm. glad you mm-hmm. Had that experience because mm-hmm. it was meant for negative, but we can use it
yes,
for positive.
Yes, because I'm going to turn it around.
Amen. Because we as women, we're supposed to be working. You know, everybody out here, and you, this is a good testimony. You have about 5 minutes. I really want you to talk about this. But the reason that a lot of women are doing some of the things they're doing is that they're looking for a mate.
Yes.
And they've been told about a Boaz. Mm-hmm. And they've been told that you got to do what you have to do and look this certain way and be half naked and, you know, put on all this hair and do all these things to bait someone in. But, you know, God took me recently back to Rebecca. And it wasn't about Rebecca, but she became the highlight
yes.
because Abraham was sending his servant. I was really talking about faith, and I visualized these things that they were happening. Abraham has his faith in God. It's not physical at all mm-hmm. because at this point that I'm getting ready to bring up, he's blind.
Mm-hmm.
He can't walk.
Right.
He can have here.
Okay.
And so what he has to do is he tells his servant, hey, come put your hand under my thigh and make an oath to me that you're going to go find my son, Isaac, a wife from where we're from. Right?
See?
And he says, this is by faith because he can't do anything. And there's a point where you get outside of the fact of your own works. You have to rely on your faith in God.
You do.
And so the servant says, well, how can I do this? I don't know where I'm going. He says, the God that I serve
Come
is
on.
Going to go before you.
See?
He says, the God that I've walked before is going to go before you. Mm-hmm. He's going to show you what to do. Now, Abraham doesn't know how this is going to turn out. But I want to put the spotlight on Rebecca because Rebecca comes out not knowing that this servant has prayed. He stops. He says, hey, God, whoever waters and gives me water
See?
And gives my animals water, she's working, minding her own business, just
right.
doing what she's supposed to
right.
do. She's not looking at her hair in the mirror, selfied up. Mm-hmm. She's doing what she's supposed to do. And she has no idea when this guy comes up that he's not just her guy, but he's the guy to the guy.
Right.
And we can't even serve men or women for that matter, without what are we gonna get out of it? Is this my husband? If you're not my husband, I can't serve you. She sees this guy and she says, hey, he never asked her, I'm gonna give you some water and I'm gonna water your animals too.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And this man says, this is the one. Now, what if she had been somewhere looking at herself on... And trying to be.
And
lustful
not
to the
doing,
eye.
See.
But not being what a woman mm-hmm. really is supposed to be. And it mm-hmm. doesn't have to be the title of a wife, but you're just supposed to be doing, you're supposed to be redeeming the time. Be found redeeming the time that you have. And a lot of times that's not redeeming the time, just I've spent so much money on the outside that I really don't know who I am on the
yes.
inside.
See.
There's nothing there. I'm an empty box.
See.
The Christmas tree box, you know the one?
Right. Just make it look pretty.
Mm-hmm. It's just, yeah. It's so pretty,
but
right?
But what's in here? What's in here? Because I have the scripture that I'd like to share. Your beauty should not come from outward adornment, such as elaborate hairstyles and the wearing of gold jewelry or fine clothes. Rather, it should be that of your inner self, the unfading beauty of a gentle and quiet spirit, which is of great worth in God's sight. That's 1 Peter 3, 3 and 4. That says a lot right there.
That says a lot.
Yeah.
That's scripture. And we're so obsessed with how I look that now I'm obsessed with how you look to the point where you come to try to put my microphone on. Well, your makeup. You think you...
Yeah,
you think that cute that you can just come out here without no makeup? Because I don't think I'm that cute that I can come out here with no makeup. So you can't. But this was an experience that you had.
It was quite an experience.
And that's a realistic experience. Mm-hmm. And that's what really is going on out here. And there are exceptions. You know, I don't want to throw everybody in the boat. Because sometimes when you say things, well, not me. I'm not like, that's not about you. It's about people like the one that you experienced. And even our girls are falling into that trap of
just
be so adorned. On the outside that you don't care about building yourself up on the inside.
It's
and then you
so
still think that you're going to be of value to anybody else, whether that's a husband, whether that's a ministry, whether that's an employee, whoever, yourself for that matter. You spend so much time trying to do implants. I mean, they're doing implants. They have liposuctions. There's so much going on out here. And we're competing with something that's not even real.
See, say that one more time. That
is competing with something that's not even real. And that's a false fight and it's a waste of time.
It is.
And with that being said, Jennifer, you know we're gonna have you back because we have to finish this conversation. This is
a
very, very important conversation and thank you for bringing it up. It's an issue that we need to talk about. And be found redeeming the times. I understand if you want to be cute, but don't be so cute that you can't get anything done. You know I won't tell you guys the truth. I love you so much. Thank you for visiting me and Jennifer Eichelberger. She does Atlanta Live, so tune into that weeknights from 7 to 8:30. I love you guys. I'll see you next time. You've been on the move with JoAnna Ward.